Hey everyone, and welcome back to the fourth episode of Engines of BC Rail. I'm sorry that today's episode is way too late. It was supposed to come out last week, but unfortunately I was very sick, so I couldn't release it in time. Anyways, moving on to today's topic, the Bud RDC. The Bud Rail Diesel Car, otherwise known as the RDC, Bud Car, or Bud Liner, is a self-propelled diesel multiple unit, otherwise known as a DMU, rail car. Between 1949 and 1962, 398 RDCs were built by the Bud Company of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, located in the United States. The cars were primarily adopted for passenger service in rural areas with low traffic density or in short-haul commuter service, and were less expensive to operate in this context than a traditional diesel locomotive drawn, trained with coaches. The cars could be used singly or coupled together in train sets and controlled from the cab of the front unit. The RDC was one of the very few DMU trains to achieve commercial success in North America. RDC trains were an early example of self-contained diesel multiple unit trains, an arrangement now in common use by railways all over the world. Bud RDCs were sold to operators in North America, South America, Asia, and Australia. They saw extensive use in the Northeast United States, both on branch lines and in commuter service. As passenger service declined in the United States, the RDC was often the last surviving conveyor of passengers on a particular route. Most RDCs were retired by the 1980s. In Canada, RDCs have remained in continuous use since their introduction in the 1950s. The RDC inspired several derivatives, including the unsuccessful Bud SPV-2000. And one railway did something unbelievable to one of their RDCs. The New York Central Railroad strapped two jet engines to an RDC in 1966 and set a United States speed record of 184 miles per hour, although this experimental configuration was never used in regular service. The self-propelled rail car was not a new concept in the North American railroading. Beginning in the 1880s, railroads experimented with steam-powered rail cars on branch lines, where the cost of operating a conventional steam locomotive hauled set of cars was prohibitive. These cars failed for several reasons. The boiler and engine were too heavy, water and fuel took up too much space, and high maintenance cost eliminated whatever advantage was gained from reducing labor costs. In the 1900s, steam rail cars gave way to gasoline, led by the McKean Motor Car Company, which produced 152 between 1905 and 1917. The J.G. Brill Company sold over 300 rail buses in the 1920s. The newcomer Electromotive Corporation, working with the Winton Motor Carriage Company, dominated the market at the end of the 1920s, but had exited it completely by 1932, as the Great Depression gutted rail traffic. The Bud Company entered the market in 1932, just as EMC exited. Up to that time, Bud was primarily an automotive parts subcontractor, but it had pioneered methods for working with stainless steel, including the technique of shot welding to join pieces of stainless steel. This permitted the construction of cars which were both light and strong. Bud partnered with Michelin to construct several rubber-tired stainless steel rail cars, powered by gasoline and diesel engines. These saw service with the Reading Company, Pennsylvania Railroad, and Texas and Pacific Railway. The cars were underpowered, the tires were prone to blowouts and derailments, and the cars were unsuccessful. Now, let's talk about the Bud RDC's designs and variants. During the years of the Second World War, there were improvements in the lightweight Detroit diesel engines, and just as importantly, the hydraulic torque converter. Bud, which by then had produced more than 2,500 streamlined cars for various railroads, took a standard 85-foot coach design and added a pair of 200 275 horsepower, 6-cylinder Detroit Diesel Series 110 engines. Each drove an axle through a hydraulic torque converter derived from the M46 patent tank for a 1A-A1 rail arrangement. The top speed for the design was 85 miles per hour. The control systems allowed the cars to operate singly or in multiple. The result was the RDC-1, which made its public debut at Chicago's Union Station on September 19, 1949. Bud manufactured 5 basic variants of the RDC. The RDC-1, an 85-foot all-passenger coach seating 90 passengers, it weighed 118,300 pounds. The RDC-2, an 85-foot baggage and passenger coach configuration, seating 70 passengers. The baggage area was 17 feet long. It weighed 114,200 pounds. The RDC-3, an 85-foot variant with a railway post office, a baggage compartment, and 48 passenger seats. It weighed 117,900 pounds. The RDC-4, a 73-foot 10-inch variant with only the railway post office and baggage area. It weighed 109,200 pounds. And finally, the RDC-9, an 85-foot passenger trailer seating 94, a single 300-horsepower engine and no control cab. Several railroads use the designation RDC-5. The Canadian Pacific Railway for RDC-2s converted to full coach configuration, and the Canadian National Railway for RDC-9s. It purchased from the Boston and Maine Railroad. Some railways that owned the Bud RDC were, and some still are, Santa Fe, Baltimore and Ohio, Boston and Maine, CNCP, Via Rail, Central Railroad of New Jersey, Chicago and Eastern Illinois, Chicago and Northwestern, and BC Rail. However, there are still many more to list. Like any other BC Rail unit, BC Rail's Bud RDCs came equipped with the Nathan K5H air horn. Here's an example. Unfortunately, in the present day, there are very few operating RDCs that still exist. Via Rail has a few operating in Ontario and other parts of Eastern Canada. CN has a track geometry unit, which is a rebuilt Bud RDC numbered CN1501. And finally, there are very few RDCs that carry on BC Rail's and Pacific Great Eastern's legacy paint scheme. They are both located in the Railway Museum of British Columbia up in Squamish. Well, I think that leaves this episode on a good note. If you did enjoy, make sure to drop a like or even subscribe. I will be doing a poll on what engine I should do next. Anyways, I will see you all next time on Engines of BC Rail.